This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now.
What
the voice of the must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
What's up, bros and hoes, snitches and bitches, and you sexy, sexy motherfuckers out there in internet land?
Yes, hello, hello, hello.
We are Jay and Casey, as always.
Yes, how's everyone doing? I hope you're doing okay. Not getting hit by any Korean missiles or anything?
What a fucking world we're in right now. But yeah. First, let's talk about getting drunk.
Yes. It's always good to start drinking at like noon. This week's beer is something light, I think. I think it's going to be light. The name of it sounds light. I've never heard of this company. It's actually called Newport, Rhode Island, I guess.
Newport, Rhode Island? No way.
Yeah. I have a picture of it here. It is a spring Irish red ale.
Sounds good.
Yes. I love red ales. It's one of my favorite types of beers.
Yeah, I'm a fan. I like red ale. IPAs can get too heavy sometimes. Stouts, as much as I love them, they can get a little heavy.
Yeah.
When you want to just sit and have a few beers, you know, a red ale is a good option to go for.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a session beer. It's not a, you know, I love a big beer, but I'm going to sit there and sip one and be done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's the thing.
You can pound away.
Yeah, I think this is going to be pretty light, but... I also got it because, you know, spring's coming up, and it had the word fucking spring on it, so I was like, why the fuck not?
Label's cool.
Yeah, I know, I like it, I think it's pretty cool. But like I said, I've never heard of these guys, so I'm actually pretty interested in trying it. So let's go ahead and abuse our liver.
All right, cheers. That's yummy.
That is really good. Actually hoppy for a red ale, don't you think?
Eh, maybe a little, you know.
That's probably the hoppiest red ale I think I've ever had.
I don't know about that.
Really? I think most red ales have like a more of a malt taste. This is actually pretty hoppy. More actually flavor than I thought it would.
It's a crispy kind of... you're getting a little bit of that... I don't know. I'm not getting a whole lot of hop, to tell you the truth.
Really?
I'm getting some malt. I'm getting a little bit of that...
grapefruit taste.
No. It's kind of like a banana clove sort of thing.
Banana clove? I don't even know what the fuck that is.
You get that flavor from some of the lighter yeast.
No, really. Yeast infections. Some of those lighter yeast infections.
I can tell you never go on Beer Advocate.
No, I don't. I drink to get the pain away. That's about it. I'm not like sitting there going, yes, quite. This beer is indubitably delicious.
Indubitably.
Yeah, I'm just like, give me a fucking beer to get this emotional wreck out of my body. I do like it, though. Actually, one of the better Irish red ales.
You know, I'm almost detecting almost sort of a piney taste.
Really?
Sort of like when we had that spruce beer. It's got a tiny little hint of that kind of evergreen sort of flavor to it.
Yeah, I can see that, actually.
It's a little bit of citrus, a little bit of...
Maybe they did it on purpose because of the spring, I don't know, theme they're going on here.
I don't know.
I actually really like it. Newport, yeah, I've never heard of you before, but you rock, yeah. I guess.
Good,
maybe the whole name of the microbrewery is Newport Storm. I don't know. I guess. I don't know. Because Rhode Island gets hit by hurricanes or something. I don't know.
Yeah. Actually, the company is a Coastal Extreme Brewing Company.
Coastal Extreme.
But their website is NewportStorm.com, so maybe that's just the branding.
Yeah, it says microbrewery, so I don't know.
I don't know. It's good. It's really good. It's not like the strongest beer you'll ever have. It's not the most exciting, but it's tasty.
Yeah. If I would rate this, I'd say probably about a 4.5. I'm gonna go 4.5 Korean failed missile tests out of 5. I think it's delicious.
I can't wait to see what you put on the fucking YouTube video for that. Casey's in charge of the graphics for the rating thing. He comes up with these off the top of his head.
Yeah, I do. Like,
he
doesn't
think about it.
Yeah, I don't really think about it at all. I'm just like, hey, whatever.
I'll go 4.
Yeah. I think it's delicious. It's one of the better beers we've had on this show. It's very, very delicious. I highly recommend it. Lots of flavor going on for a spring, I guess you would say.
Yeah, it's a red ale, but it's got a little bit different shit going on with it. I like
it. Yeah, it does. I've never had a red ale like this. It's actually really fucking delicious, so I suggest drinking it.
In a few weeks here, I got a vacation, maybe a month and a half from now, I get a vacation coming up in Ocean City, Maryland. They have a brewing company down there called Ocean City Brewing Company.
Surprise, surprise.
Surprise, surprise. If I don't drink it all while I'm down there, I took a brewery tour last year, and they had some decent beers. Mm. If I don't drink it all while I'm down there, I'm going to get a growler and bring it up, and we can sample that on one of our shows.
And you better bring me some salt water motherfucking taffy.
You can buy that at the grocery store.
No, you can't.
There's nothing inherently...
If it's not close to an ocean, it ain't salt water taffy, damn it.
There ain't even any salt water in it.
Ah, oh, man. Yeah, I'm all excited because it's Cadbury egg season, speaking of candy. No one likes Cadbury eggs.
I love the damn things.
I thought you hated... Oh, that's your mother. Yeah, your mother hates them.
Well, she's crazy.
Yeah, that's true. I just know a lot of people that hate Cadbury eggs. They bring it up, they're like...
Yeah, it's because they're slimy.
I that's great.
Remember, I attempted to make my own one year, and they were good, except for they were fucking huge, and you couldn't finish one?
Yeah, I know, because they were... And that's the thing. Cadbury eggs are just the perfect size, because they're so sickening sweet. After you're done with them, you're like, oh, okay, that was enough.
Oh, Jesus. That's adorable.
It ain't a show unless I burp into the microphone. But, yeah, I don't know. And that's the thing. Like, a lot of these bitches I know, they're like, Cadbury's are disgusting. They're slimy. I'm like, how many loads did you swallow, bitch?
Jesus Christ.
Fucking Christ, man. Yeah, so the world is going crazy. We have a bunch of shit going on in North Korea.
Yeah, what the fuck is going on with the world right now? Holy shit.
I don't know, man.
Last week, we didn't really talk about anything serious because of Jason and Ashley being on. We just made jokes, but Jesus Christ.
I know. It's sort of nice having elbow room in here. Yeah. We've had so many... Don't touch me, you freak. We've had so many guests on here and everything like that. It's
I'm weird. Telling you, man, we need to get another camera. I'm moving my desk on the other side of the room. Fuck you. You smell bad.
Actually, look at this camera right now. Do I look like I'm losing weight? I just...
You look like you're losing hair.
Yeah. Oh, that's been my whole life. But I'm looking at this. I'm like, I feel like I'm...
Which way to the beach?
That way.
Someone call a vet. These swans are sick.
I don't know if I'm losing anything or not. Probably not. It would take me 100 pounds for anybody to notice a difference.
Yeah, how long has it been since the vegetarian thing going on right now?
I don't know. I haven't really been keeping track.
Yeah.
Over a month.
Yeah.
I don't know. We can probably go back on the show and
and find the part where you pooped your shit. Or pooped your shit. Not awake yet today. Pooped yourself.
Yeah, with the vasectomy, I'd only been on it for like a week at that time.
Yeah. Are you past 40 loads yet?
No. I'm like, close.
I'm close, damn it.
There's God, a couple, man. I didn't account for because I forgot to carve them into the bedpost. But
I feel bad for your wife once you get past 40, man.
I still got to convince her. It's not like...
And, like her cervix or whatever is going to look like the back of a backboard on a basketball hoop that gets, hit with the ball the most, and there's like this black spot.
Or it's gone with like hamburger or something, but whatever.
Yeah, it's going to be ridiculous, man.
Are you insinuating my dick leaves a black streak?
I don't know what your dick does. I don't want to know.
But hey, let's go over all this shit, man. Yeah. We had a tiny despot in North Korea attempt to launch off rockets, which failed. We had our own tiny despot manage to launch rockets, which succeeded. We have fucking, Syria. We got people gassing our own people. We dropped a fucking mother of all bombs, one of 20 that are going to expire by next year. So I'd imagine our tangerine Fuhrer is going to attempt to use the rest of them up.
Yeah, what's probably funny is this is probably in a contract that it's like, hey, you have to use these before they expire. We get our money back or something ridiculous.
Yeah, chances are he realized now that launching bombs gives him a slightly more favorable opinion than angry tweets. So he's we might be in trouble.
He's like, fuck Twitter. He's like, I just bomb people and people start listening. But the funny thing is I was reading about this mother of all bombs because we've had them forever. We've used them for a while and stuff.
2007, I think.
Yeah, they become more popular lately because of, Cheeto dropping them. But they only cost, don't quote me on this, but they only cost a couple $100,000. And I was really shocked by that. But now that I think of it, there's no guidance system. And it's just a fucking, a lot of fucking oomph. Like, they just drop them. There's no guidance. There's nothing like that. So I guess it makes sense. But it just shocked me. I think it was like $150,000 or something they cost. That's it. And it's like, what, cruise missiles cost millions of dollars, I think.
Well, you know, guidance system. They got, yeah, you got to pilot them into shit that you're going to blow up.
Yeah. I think we should just use orphans to pilot them, but whatever.
Oh, you're so wonderful. As somebody who sort of was one, at least partially, you think...
I wasn't an orphan.
No, you're a bastard.
I just didn't know my father, yeah.
You're not an orphan, you're
like
a bastard.
I'm like Jon Snow. All you Game of Thrones fans out there. Oh, man. That's something I can't wait for. The next season's coming up here soon, and yeah, it's the second to last season.
Oh, I'm happy we got iZombie back.
Yeah, I got to catch up on that. Please, yeah, don't tell me.
All right, right, I won't say anything
because I got to catch up on that. I still want to lick her fucking butthole. Mm.
Better Call Saul. That's back on. That's really. Yeah.
They're still. That's the second season.
Oh no, that we're on season three now.
Holy fuck, man! I feel like that. I just remember seeing the previews for that coming out. Holy crap. They're fucking moving right along with that.
Well, you still haven't like watched all of Breaking Bad yet.
No, I couldn't. I got way too into Game of Thrones. Like, I was watching Breaking Bad, and I was watching, what was the other one? The Walking Dead. And they were good and all, and I was really into them. It's just then I saw Game of Thrones, and my life just got turned upside down.
Well, I know what it is. It's because there's instant gratification with Game of Thrones, whereas it...
No,
it's a very slow sizzle with.
No, yeah. It is very slow with Game of Thrones. Trust me. Well,
bullshit. There was beheadings in the first episode.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about character development. And everything.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm
like Game
saying.
Of Thrones, they make you fall in love or hate characters. Like I've said, people that are like, "Oh, I want to watch Game of Thrones. What's it like?" And I basically just tell them, I've never watched something where I've hated and loved fictional characters so much in my life, to the point where you're like. Affected by it so badly, you're just like, like, you're so pissed. I remember the one episode, I won't spoil it, but I'll just call it The Red Wedding.
Everybody, I've never seen Game of Thrones, and I know what The Red Wedding is.
And I remember sitting there, and I'm just, and someone made a joke about this. They're like, I know why Game of Thrones credits are so plain at the end, because when it just comes onto a black screen, you just see yourself. and that's the thing. After the Red Wedding, the screen just went black and the credits started. And I look into my computer and I just see my face like, and I'm like, holy. And I walked around. I remember walking around my house for like 15 minutes, just saying what the fuck to myself. Like I was like, what the fuck just happened? Like it's like. And that's something I do when I get a girl pregnant or something. I'm like, where did I leave those hangers? And it's just amazing. Anyone that hasn't seen Game of Thrones, I suggest watching it. It's very dialogue heavy, but it's worth it. Trust me. Don't watch it high.
I broke my mic stand last week when I threw it.
Yeah. So what else is going on? We have the missile thing going on.
We got that fucking random dude in Cleveland just going out and stabbing old folks.
Yeah. That's fucking retarded.
I saw a picture of somebody who said, if you shoot this guy, we promise not to riot. Signed black folks.
Yeah, I thought that was funny. I saw that.
I'm pretty sure they'd be okay with that.
Yeah.
So somebody shoots him. I don't think there's gonna be
I've seen him all over the place and stuff, but I haven't really looked into a lot of it. Is it just old people? Like he's just targeting old people?
Well, he says he's killed multiple people at this point because he's clearly mentally ill, but as far as we know, it's only one.
It's only one. Okay. Yeah, because you cannot not see this guy. He's all over Facebook. He's all over Instagram. He's just like...
I hope by the time that he... Or by this airs, hopefully they've got him.
Mm-hmm.
They thought they had a scare where they thought he might have been in Philly, and then they went to investigate, and it wasn't him. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, now that you mention it, I'm getting a lot more pine with this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. It's a little off topic, but yeah. Just felt like I sucked off a spruce. Yeah, and that's the thing. I wanted to talk about North Korea thing. Like, I always hear people bitching about, you know, oh, they have missiles, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, dude, a lot of countries can't they just can't get a fucking rocket off the ground. I don't think people realize how hard it is to launch a missile. Like, it's not that easy. That's why we spent a lot of money trying to do it during the 50s and 40s and all that bullshit.
I saw a GIF floating around. It made me laugh. I said GIF, not GIF. You can come at me in the comments, bro. Anyway, I saw a GIF floating around, a little chubby bastard watching this whole launch, and his face just fucking melts. It's hilarious. He's like all smiles and shit, and then it blows up. He's like, oh.
Yeah, speaking of GIF or whatever like that, there's this fucking, all right, I'm just going to mention it for a second, but it's going. World of Warcraft. There's a trinket in there that drops, and it's spelled D-R-A-U-G-H-T. And it is causing an uprising right now.
Well, that's draft.
Exactly.
It's spelled weird, but that's people if you drink calling, beer.
Yeah. It, when you Google it, it says a British word for draft. Like
Well, look at a Guinness bottle.
I know.
Guinness draft. Yeah. And that's how it's spelled.
And that's how
it's not Guinness draught.
I know. And I'm like, guys, when you go to dictionary.com, you can listen to how it's pronounced, and it's pronounced draft. And people are like freaking out, man. And this trinket or whatever, this gear that drops, it came out, I'd say 3-4 months ago, and people are still talking about it. It's just so funny to me. And I'm like, guys, it's draft. And we had a British guy, and he's like, it's fucking draft.
And you're fucking daft. You bloody wankers.
And that's the thing. I was playing with my friends, and I haven't played with them in a while. And they're like, hey, we got a British guy. And I'm like, oh, okay. So I'm thinking when he comes into the channel, and he starts talking, he's like, oh, good day, you know, blah, blah, blah. It is fucking like street soccer hooligan British.
Got that cockney.
Yeah, out. Like, it's like, like, it's so, it's like, let's go for the point. It's so crazy. It's so thick.
Openly Hostile Opinions does not wish to discriminate against our British viewers. Sorry.
Yeah, we do. Sorry. It's like chaff.
Dude, come on. I know we have at least 2 British viewers.
Oh, do we?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Not anymore.
No, but here's the thing. British viewers that you said, quote me on this. You guys don't like this thing called chavs, right? Am I right? Is that like a big, not a problem, but sort of like a weird thing over there right now where these people, they wear a lot of sweatpants, gold chains, and they're called chavs, I think, and they talk like that.
Slavs?
No, it's called chavs. I've never heard, maybe that's it, but I'm
not. Well, Slavs are like Slavic people.
No, these are British people, and they're called chavs, I think.
Yeah.
And because I used to watch this girl, she used to stream stuff about like her life, and she was talking about it coming over from England, that it was nice to wear sweatpants in America. And I was like, what the hell? And she started going into it. She said, well, a lot of chavs over there. I'm probably saying that wrong. You better Google that. Chavs over there wear sweatpants and jewelry. So people that don't want to be associated
this
with them.
This has got to be something ethnic. And you are just slurring the fuck out.
a white guy getting racial stuff wrong in a small country area. That never happens. This was a while ago when I was first finding out about this, so I could be wrong.
Chav. Okay, we got it. The Oxford Dictionary defines chav as an informal British derogatory, meaning a young, lower-class person who displays brash and loutish behavior and wears real or imitation designer clothing.
Yes. Yes. Okay. That sounds just like
so it. They must wear tracksuits and shit.
Yeah, they wear tracksuits, and that's like she was saying about how she didn't wear a lot of gold jewelry. Because then they associate you with chavs. And I was just like, God, you can't even wear fucking jewelry? Like, what do you buy your girlfriend?
Apparently.
The plan B pill. Go on. What are you saying?
Well, apparently it is sort of ethnic because the word comes from Romani, which is the correct way of saying gypsy. Gypsy is an ethnic slur.
Oh, okay.
So, like, Romanese or Romanis or however the hell you pronounce it, gypsies, mm-hmm. That's the word where it came from. It means child for them.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably where it came from.
Okay. Yeah, I knew I wasn't making that up, and I'm pretty sure I was announcing it. I wanted to say chive for some reason, but I'm like, no, I'm pretty sure it's chav. and it's just, I don't know, it's pretty interesting. I never heard about it until, like I said, I was watching this girl's stream, and she was just talking about it, but I thought that was pretty interesting to see what other countries what other countries deal with and stuff like that. Actually, speaking of that, I wanted to talk about something. I found this interesting article, and it's an article that I found interesting because me and Jay think a lot of kids in America are sort of spoiled in a way that they're not very grown up, right? Is that how you pronounce it, Jay? Or said it? I forget what you said.
I'm just saying they're a bunch of little bitches with participation trophies who never learn that failure is a possibility.
Yeah,
and it's
exactly.
something you need to learn to grow from and learn from and not, you know, ruin your self-esteem and go cry to your, you know.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, I really wish they would teach you in school that you're going to fail and you're going to get your heart broken. So just get used to it.
Like, everybody fails.
Yeah,
everybody fucks up.
Hell, look at all the people that are successful now and read their stories. Like Oprah, she was fired from her first job. Michael Jordan got kicked off the basketball team from high school.
That reminds me. I heard a rumor that Oprah is running for president in 2020.
Oh,
she's
God.
Considering it. She'll win, too. No question. No question
won't.
About it. She'll
actually,
win.
You know how she'll win? Because she'll like, you get a new car. You get health care. You get health care.
No, she'll get the housewife vote.
Yeah, probably.
All of them.
Well, that's what they thought about Hillary. I mean, Killary, sorry.
God, you're awful.
I know, I am. But, so I was reading this article about what they do in other countries with their kids that Americans would find just very disturbing. And I thought this was pretty interesting. And they list six things. The first one here, I've actually seen American people do this a lot, and people freak the fuck out. But in other countries, they actually have a little picture of it here I want to show you. They leave their kids out in the street a lot.
like while they run into the store?
Yes. And I've seen someone do this. It was a video, I think, a couple years I seen in America, and people freak the fuck out. But it's very, very normal in other countries. They actually have special spots for them.
I mean, if you can trust your neighbors enough to do that, then okay. I don't think that one's terrible.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I wouldn't do it, but it's mostly just a matter of not trusting anybody enough to do it.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I could do it, but other countries are more...
That's a European thing?
Yeah, it's a European thing. A lot of, like, Scandinavian countries, too, and everything like that, they do it. But a lot of people are more trusting, I would say, in other countries because there's more of a community. People in America, they basically stick together in their own house, and that's about it. You say hi to your neighbor, maybe.
Oh, well, there's a story here I'm seeing from over here. Somebody did it in America? Is that what happened?
Yeah, yeah, and that's what
read that off. That's what could be interesting.
But two, let's see here. Americans tend to freak out to the sight of an unattended children. Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Right, yeah, okay.
As a Danish tourist found out in 1997 while visiting a city, her and her husband decided to eat at an East Village restaurant, but hiring a babysitter or ordering takeout, or we don't know. Maybe taking their child to the restaurant with them. They left their daughter parked in her stroller on the sidewalk. Not one, but two different worried New Yorkers took the time to walk into the restaurant in hopes of finding the abandoned parents, begging whoever owned this child just to get her off the street. The store alone is worth at least $30 in Times Square. They probably argued.
New Yorkerly?
Yeah, New Yorkerly.
You know, in fact, that New Yorkers cared enough to even say anything is kind of impressive.
Hey, what's this kid doing here? Hey. hey. The couple refused leaving their baby outside for a whole hour while they enjoyed dinner. The locals called the cops, which is why the couple was arrested for child endangerment. And they lost custody of their kid for a day.
To be fair, it's New York City.
Yeah. But that's the thing. Like, it's very normal over there because being a bartender and everything, what I've heard, I've mentioned this on previous shows, other countries say America lacks community. A lot of other countries, everyone pretty much knows each other, and it's more of a community.
Well,
so
where
I think
we live, it would probably be, I mean, you still get the cops called on you, but I'm just saying we have community here. Yeah. But, you know, in New York City, you don't leave your fucking kid unattended. No. There's crazy people there.
I know, like...
A lot of them.
You'd be like, where'd my kid go? And then you see some guy with a table like, we got babies. We got cell phone case.
Yo, you want to buy this Rolex? Yo, you want to buy this toddler? I got this toddler, man. I know,
he just keeps pulling up. He's like, Rolexes? He's like, cell phone cases? Toddlers?
What you need, man? What you need?
This is a small picture, but you can sort of see right here that this street is just lined with baby carriages. Like, that's just how normal it is. That's just...
Yeah, but what do they do if one of them starts crying or needs something or shits themselves and starts crying?
I don't know. They say, I don't have any kids or whatever, I guess. Well, they say that you're not always supposed to give your kids attention. Don't quote me on that, but I've heard.
Yeah, well, how would you like to shit? It's sitting your own shit.
I do that when I'm wasted. Like, what?
Yeah, don't you get diaper rash then?
No, I pretty much pass out, wake up. I'm like, oh, I shit myself again. Yeah, there's a bunch of pictures out of here. Next thing we have is Nordic kids sleep outside in the sub-zero temperatures.
I'm not really that surprised by that.
I know, but it's actually pretty funny because there's a picture of it here of what they do with them. They even put a thermometer on them so they can tell when to bring them in, I guess. I don't know. It says, for generations, Northern European moms have seen the bitter air of old man winter as a healthy supplement to their babies. So they're basically saying, get them used to it because they're going to be cold their whole lives. So I thought that was pretty interesting. They just basically bundle up their kids and leave them outside. And there's actually an interesting story.
The most metal thing
I know, dude. Like, now you know why there's a lot of metal music over there.
It's like, my baby will grow stronger from the cold air.
I know. It's like fucking 300 shit or something like that. Like, hey, when you're 5, go and kill this wolf. But yeah,
it will grow strong. Yeah,
I thought that was pretty funny.
This is how you want. This is how you get Euronymous. Is this how you want Euronymous? Is this how you want Varg?
Yeah, no.
Varg Vikernes.
And that's the thing. Like, I also working at a bar. I've seen a lot of foreign people, and there's some. I've seen some people from Scandinavian regions. They're big fucking dudes. I remember
tall, blonde, and scary.
Yeah, and I could tell why, because you fucking freeze hate into them.
That's how you end up with Varg Vikernes.
Yeah, because I worked at this one bar, and they hired this bouncer, and he came over from I think it was Norway or something to play football, and he was fucking huge. And it's just, holy shit, people. This one's
actually, yeah, but they talk like the Swedish chef.
Yeah, I know. Oh, ruskadoodle.
All those Nordic languages in that region, all those people who come from the Gauls, they all have that kind of, it's almost a sing-songy sort of language.
Yeah, there was a video a while ago where I seen this guy, he was climbing some mountain or something. It was very snowy and shit, and he was filming himself, and he buried food somewhere and he forgot where, so he kept searching for it, and finally he found it, and there was Cheetos or something in there. It was like, oh, the cheese doodles. It was so funny. I fucking lost.
But he was badass enough to just wander around in the freezing sub-zero temperature.
He was so happy though. He was like, oh, cheese doodles. All right,
you almost got Italian there. That, yeah. Oh, the cheese doodles. Hey.
No, I didn't get Italian because I didn't say hard salami.
You only have like one accent for everybody.
I know.
Got the cheese doodles. Hey, hey.
Hey. This one's more common. You know, it says number 4 is letting kids drink beer is way more common than you think.
You know, I agree with that. I think we're way too fucking big of pussies when it comes to alcohol.
Yeah, I know. And that's the thing. Like, a lot of kids just drink because you can't. It's exciting. It's new. It's just whatever.
Yeah, we have such a backasswards belief about alcohol. It's so stupid.
Especially Pennsylvania, because we have a lot of like Quakers and stuff like that.
There are no such thing as Quakers anymore, but we are founded by Quakers.
Well, that's what I'm saying. We were founded by Quakers. There isn't Quakers anymore, but we still come from that way of thinking.
Well, the United States was somewhat formed by puritanical people. So we have a lot of this. That's why we're so friggin' afraid of sex in this country, too.
Yeah, I know, which sex is awesome.
Yeah, but we don't like talking about it. It's embarrassing. Yeah. I'm as guilty as anybody.
Yeah, I know, exactly. Number 3 here. I thought this was interesting. Vietnamese moms train their babies to pee on command.
Of course they do.
While they're doing math problems, they forgot to forgot that part at the end. I'm just joking. But yeah, this one, yeah, you have to read into it a little bit because it's actually more abusive, I would say, than just the title. But basically, they feed their kids whiskey.
Those motherfuckers.
And I don't know what age do you start potty training at? Would you say?
Well, you start as early as you really can.
Yeah. So
I mean, they really, really get it for real. Mm-hmm. In that they do it consistently every time by the time they're like three, but okay. I mean they start earlier. You start earlier than that.
Okay. Well, I was reading a little bit about it, and they says, here's how it happens. As soon as the Vietnamese babies are born, their moms give a special whistle every time they notice their newborns urinate, which can be up to 12 times a day. If they pay attention. So walking to a Vietnamese newborn nursery must be walking through an aviary at sunrise. here's when things get a little weird. In the same way that the famous doctor, Pavlov, Jesus Christ, trained his dogs to salivate at the sound of a bell, Vietnamese moms train their babies to piss at the sound of a whistle. And it works.
This is your quality content for today. We're ripping it off from a cracked article. But hey, why not?
No, I can't believe I mispronounced Pavlov. I studied him a lot. Jesus Christ. By the age of 3 months, their moms hold their kids over toilets, give it a little whistle, and their kids urinate a command like magic. And it says, it actually says right here, it says this is actually, so they're potty trained by 9 months.
The convenience.
Yeah, I'm going to try this.
No, ladies, stay away. Look at this face. Stay away.
Yeah, I'll be looking through your windows.
You'd be like a cop from like a week or two ago masturbating in people's picture windows.
You'd be like, I got to polish my Glock in this backyard.
Oh, God.
Okay, number two here. Some Chinese moms. A lot of Asian theme going on here.
Yeah, well, they created Bruce Lee, so far away from me, bitch.
I know. And Jackie Chan. I love you, Jackie. I'm sorry you're getting old. I miss you.
You still kick your ass.
I know, but I just love Jackie Chan. Oh, he's so great. So, like I said, some Chinese moms abandon their newborns for months.
Oh, good.
Right after birth, if you got a dilemma on your hand. On one hand, you might feel some level of affection for your baby, encouraging to spend time with your newborn. On the other, pregnancy was hard. You want to relax, and the baby kind of gets in the way of that. Whoever wrote this, you're awesome.
Crack does have some funny ass writing.
Yeah, it does.
I've stolen a few things from there over the years.
It basically says here that for about a month, they just get rid of the baby. It really doesn't say where they take it, though.
Oh, good.
headphones. I was trying to figure that out, and it doesn't really say. But it says that they are avoided, or they are told to avoid housework and sex after they have a baby. But I guess they want more than that, so they just fucking abandon their kid for a month.
I think dad has to take over, is what I'm getting from this.
Yeah, there's a picture of a dad. He doesn't look very Vietnamese. I don't know. Maybe he is.
No, it's a stock photo.
Yeah. So
I think it just means moms are encouraged to abandon the kids. It's not like they throw them in the fucking closet and come back a month later.
Yeah, and I just didn't get that because in America, we just throw them at dumpsters. or we Casey Anthony and just, you know, drown it and say, hey, let's go party.
My God.
I think that's why Casey Anthony did it.
Why did I let you? Why do I let you babysit my children?
I don't know. That's the thing. I used to babysit a lot of children, actually. They love me because I am a child. But
yeah, you never tell them no.
I know, exactly. And the last one here, in Kenya, I guess, it's not really a sin or anything like that, but they don't make eye contact with their babies.
What kind of fucked up weird ass shit is that?
I don't know. But they basically do it to they hold them and stuff like that, but they don't do eye contact with them because it's a way of showing them not to be too reliant on somebody, I guess, was the way I read it.
You know, I'm all about not coddling your kids. Yeah. And turning it into a bunch of fucking like panty waists.
Mm-hmm.
But a little eye contact ain't gonna hurt.
Yeah, I know. Like I don't know. Whatever. So I just thought that was pretty interesting because stuff like that goes on in America. People like fucking shun you for it. Well, but I'll hell, you can't even be yourself in America without getting bullshit. So whatever.
Were there any about Australia?
No.
Okay. Well, maybe Australia needs to learn from some of these people because I got a good one for us.
What's that? Nice segue, by the way.
Thank you. Pull up that picture. You got to see this guy.
Yeah, Jay sent me a picture here because this guy is fucking amazing.
I'll tell you his story while you just gaze this in.
Oh, he's actually a rapper.
Yeah, take a look at this.
Okay, let's bring it up.
All right, just gaze this in while I tell you a tale. So this guy had a $600 bill. First off, he calls himself Tupac, which is the laziest thing I've ever heard of. I'm gonna
Tupac?
Go
Tupac.
I'm gonna go ahead and start a rap career and call myself Dr. Roy.
Dude, I'm sorry. Every time I go to get beer now, I'm like, yo, I'm going to the store and get a Tupac.
Well, now I'm Dr. Roy. Yeah, what up, G? Dr. Roy in a hizzy. Anyway, so Tupac here. Ate at a seafood restaurant, ate an unbelievable amount of food. It totaled to $600.
You eat that much food?
Well, I'll tell you. He ordered 2 lobsters, 17 oyster shooters. He actually ordered more, but only ate 17 of them. A baby octopus. Yeah. And apparently he got upset because his quote-unquote lobsters were overcooked, and there was a piece of shell in one of his oyster shooters. Oh, no.
Wow.
Shells in a shellfish? How dare they?
That is so weird.
So anyway,
there's beer in my beer bottle.
He fucking hightailed it, dove into the ocean, and started swimming away.
Of course.
The cops had to go after his dumbass with fucking jet skis. They thought that a local lifeguard's got jet skis to get him. Oh, excuse me. He was charged with 2 counts of serious assault of a police officer and banned from the restaurant for life, obviously. In fact, the judge... I couldn't believe the meal. The judge actually exclaimed, "Oh God, by himself!"
I know.
When they
a lot of rappers have like posses and hype man. So
well, he was by himself.
So weird.
Take a look at this guy, though. I mean, look at that chain. Yeah, is the picture still on the screen?
Yeah, I have it on.
All right, if you guys get a chance, look this up or go on YouTube and look at this. He's got this chain on here. You can't tell me. That's not one of them plastic chains from the hardware store that motherfucker spray painted gold.
I know, dude. Or it's like something you want at like a Fun Factory or something, yeah. Or like a David Buster's.
And what's he got on his fucking head? Is that like one of them Floam domes where you have like the 2 beer cans?
Oh, I don't know. I think they're headphones. I don't know. Because when you're a rapper, you just wear headphones everywhere.
You know what's funny, though? Take a good look. His hat's crooked.
Yeah.
But his sunglasses and headphones are on straight.
That's true. That's the style, I guess. Actually, that's probably, you know, that's probably when your hat, glasses, and headphones are like that, it's probably called a Tupac.
It is now.
Yeah, it is now. We should just start dressing like that. Be like, yo, you like my Tupac?
This guy, if you look up douchebag in the fucking dictionary, this guy's picture's here.
Yeah, this is the guy that just reminds me of, like, Breaking Benjamin fucking dudes with the tribal tattoos. I fucking hate them.
This guy's got... You know what? He's the real-life version of Scumbag Steve.
Yeah. And that's the thing. You do got to see a picture of this. If you can't go to YouTube...
Just Google Tupac. Yeah. You'll find him.
Me and Jay are actually going to do a better job at posting stuff on our Twitter and social stuff. So we'll try to get a picture of this and all the other stories that we talk about today. But you got to look this fucking freak up. He has like one of those... Like, when you look at this photo, he almost wants to do the duck face. Like, you see what I mean there? Like, he has this... little like pouty lip thing going on. I'm like, you must be real thug, dude.
Yeah, G. Although to be fair, he lives in Australia.
Yeah.
Which you know, everything wants to kill you there, including the plants. Yeah. So
I don't care. It's actually funny we're talking about this because I was just talking to my friends about this last night about how like a lot of Australian women are hot. They're fucking crazy, but they're really, really fucking hot. I don't know. Like every, it seems like every Australian woman I see is just really fucking good looking. Actually, I'm going to Google Australian women and see if it just brings up what they look like. Let's see here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Jesus Christ, man. Yeah, women are gorgeous in Australia. Holy shit. I'm starting to get a stinger.
My God.
Let's, oh, there's the swim team. There's a bunch of Australian women. There's some girl in high heels running for some reason. God, who is this? Rachel Ninnenbergen? You ever heard of her?
Nah, no.
I've never heard of her. Actually, that bitch. Oh, shit, the bitch that plays, what's her name in the Suicide Squad movie? She's Australian?
Yeah.
Oh, is she? I never knew that. Uh-oh.
Why? It's buzzing.
Why is your wife calling? Doesn't she know we got a show to do?
She forgot, I'm sure.
Oh, okay. What, she just loses you? What, is she a Chinese mother?
Oh, for God's sake. No, she. What it is, I guarantee you, she's on her break and forgot.
Oh, okay. She's working.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
She has a whole job thing going down.
Oh, okay. Actually, I did want to show something creepy here, speaking of posting stuff on social media. So, apparently, when I was younger, I don't even know if they sell these at all, but when I was younger, they had this huge toy called Tickle Me Elmo. Yeah. It was huge. Like, people were beating each other up and stuff over having this toy for some reason. And I don't get it. I don't know. I was playing with Legos. But someone thought it would be a good idea and it rip its fur off. You said you've seen this, right?
Yeah, I saw it. I saw it the other day. It's horrifying.
Yeah, and
this is another one you need YouTube for. Sorry, audio listeners.
Yeah, we have a picture of it here, and there is a video of it. But like me and Jay, we're saying we're gonna do a better job of posting stuff on our social media so we can, you know, show the stories that we're listening to, because like a lot of you do listen to our podcast and everything like that. But I'm just gonna go ahead and play this real quick. It is fucking creepy. It is. Really-
God, it looks like something that came out of Satan's butthole.
No, dude.
It's so disturbing.
She's just like, I'm going to have nightmares. Oh, man. And actually, this reminded me. Do you recall, like, back in the day, there was a lot more stuff like Tickle Me Elmo and Furbies and everything that was really, like, so crazy that made people beat each other up and stuff? There's nothing really like that anymore.
That's because we have Amazon. We'll just order it.
Yeah, exactly. Like there was.
Well, those fucking egg things. What the hell are they called?
Oh yeah, Hatchetommies or something.
Hatchimals.
Yeah, and that's actually funny. When I was watching this Tickle Me Elmo thing, you know how we were talking about like processed porn and everything a long time ago? That was like our second episode, I think.
Oh, thank God for you folks that are still with us. You poor bastards.
Well, someone, you know the hydraulic press ones.
Yeah.
Someone hydraulic pressed a Furby.
Of course they did. They'll come back from hell to attack.
Yeah. So, yeah, because I remember Tickle Me Elmo. I remember Power Rangers was a huge deal when they first came out, when their toys came out and everything. People used to wait in line for their toys and everything like that. And then Tie toys. Tie Beanie Babies, whatever the fuck they were called. Is that what they're called? Beanie Babies?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Jay's looking at porn right now. He's just
no, I'm trying to fucking I'm trying to fucking buffer that image and it refuses to take it, so fuck it. If you want to see what this douchebag looks like, look up Tupac. I'm done.
Not only does he refuse to pay bills, he refuses to get his photo uploaded. Yeah,
he refuses to be posted. I'm done. I've given up.
Jay's like,
you have Google too.
God, I don't want to see you with slow internet.
That's what they always say. If you want to see whether somebody is marriage material, put them in front of slow internet.
Yeah, I do hate slow internet. Actually, I watched this funny thing yesterday. Someone took a scene, or they explained what it's like to lose internet connection.
Yeah.
All through Jim Carrey scenes from movies, and it was hilarious.
I'd be happier losing internet than having intermittent internet issues or having it be slow.
Well, it was just funny because I remember one of my favorite Jim Carrey movies is Liar Liar. And when they go through the whole thing, they're like, oh, it going down, not knowing why. And then the last part was like, Suddenly, the internet mysteriously comes on and shows him from Liar Liar when he's drinking the water. He's like, come on! And the water shoots out. It was really funny. Look it up when you get a chance.
Liar Liar has a shitty rating and stuff. And I don't understand that. It's a brilliant movie.
That was back when movies actually had like a, you know, fucking, what's the word I'm looking for? A message. God, I can't think today.
Yeah, a message is if you wish on the birthday cake hard enough, your wishes will come true.
Know that liars or lawyers are fucking scumbags. It doesn't matter if they have kids and stuff like that. They're fucking scumbags.
You know, and Cary Elwes, you know, he is so badass in The Princess Bride. He's the epitome of a cool dude.
Uh-huh.
And in that, he's such a bitch.
I know. And I love it, too, where he's, like, playing with Max and he, like, hits him. And Jim Carrey's like, he struck the child. Did you see that?
That's my favorite. It's the claw. The claw.
He's like, he struck the child. Then that guy dents his car and he seals his air freshener. He's like, I'm taking. Such a good movie.
I think he was charging him a ridiculous amount of money to get it out of Hawk is what it was.
Yeah, and then he like scratched his car or whatever like that, and he's like, I don't see no scratch. He's like, it's right here.
Oh, yeah, I remember now.
I love that movie. I think I'm going to watch that tonight. I dreamed I'm playing WoW. Shit, I mentioned WoW again. Sorry.
Sorry. So when are you going to sell Cricket your bath towel back here?
I don't know. Cricket, if you're watching, I don't know if I could do it. I love you to death. You've been awesome lately. You've been really cool, but I don't know, man. That's my baby.
You know what? We should add her to the badass board.
Yeah, me and Jay were talking. You've been awesome lately. We just wanted to give you a shout out real quick, Cricket. You've been awesome. It's just...
Let's play the thing.
we'll get our little like poster board and everything going well. And we'll put it over there. Me and Jay were talking. You've been awesome. You've been posting, you know, comments and everything like that. And you actually, what was Heartbreak Ridge? We were talking about the thing.
Hacksaw Ridge.
Yeah, Hacksaw Ridge. She actually was a medic.
Yeah, she was a medic. So,
in Afghanistan, I think.
Thank you for your service and all that shit. So.
Is that what she said? Afghanistan, I think?
I believe.
Yeah. And she, now I'm forgetting the word again. She's going to kill me. She's going to be like, damn it, I put it in the comments. Corjective corresponder? Shit.
I don't know. You're fucking with my head now.
I'm sorry, Cricket. chirp.
I think that's her last name.
Oh, is it really?
I think so, because she has a vest. That in one of her pictures on Google Plus, she had that vest that says, like, Cricket.
Oh, okay. All right, yeah. Yeah, you've been posting comments, and you play World of Warcraft, so how fucking cool is that?
And if nothing else, this gives me an excuse to play this background music, which I fucking think is badass.
Yeah, I don't know if I could just depart with that towel. It's my baby.
if you keep wheedling him, he'll probably let it go.
Yeah, probably. I don't know. It means a lot to me. But like I said, yeah, thanks, Cricket. You've been awesome. I don't know if, So hope you keep watching us and everything like that. And me and Jay call you our cheerleader. So thanks for cheering us on.
Between you and Malcav, you're about the only people who talk. Occasionally Pocky.
Yeah. Did you find the comment?
I'm looking.
Okay.
I don't do shit fast.
That's what your wife said.
Oh, no, that on the other hand.
Yeah, no, I was giving you a compliment, actually.
Fuck you.
Is that one it?
I don't know.
We've done so many videos so far. What? I think this is actually episode 30, isn't it?
Yeah, this is episode 30. Jesus Christ.
Yeah. We've done a lot of episodes. I can't believe this was actually just a suggestion me and Jay made one day. We're like, hey, you want to do a podcast?
Oh, my God. I didn't see this comment.
What's
imagine
that?
My surprise when I found my stepdad's gay porn collection. I instantly got my stoner friends over for a viewing party. Wow, didn't see that one.
And that's the thing, Cricket. You're sick and twisted like we are.
You fit in with us well.
You fit in.
We got to get her on the show.
Yeah, we were actually talking about that, Cricket. If you want to come on the show sometime, I don't know, we'll do a Skype call or something like that.
All right, I'll shut off my Matrix music.
Actually, that does sound like the Matrix like music. I never fucking thought that.
Aha!
Did you find it?
Yeah, it's in here somewhere. Combat medic. She's a conscientious objector.
Yeah, I can never think of that. Fuck, I always forget that word for some reason.
Conscientious objector was the movie.
Yeah, I'm not saying that she's one. Yeah, I don't think she was, but in the movie he was because he didn't want to carry a rifle.
Oh, yeah, okay. That was the only war movie I watched since I came back from Afghanistan. Afghanistan.
That sounds like a canned tuna. I'm going to have me some of this Afghanistan.
Afghanistan! Can Afghan!
Yeah. So like we said, thanks again, Cricket.
Yeah, we'll get your name on the board next week. We'll slap it up there. If no other reason, is because you got badass tattoos and shit. So that's cool.
Yeah, that is cool. You're cool with us.
Yeah, I'm trying to catch up here. my wife on a whim started tattooing, which is cool. I'm getting free ones, but I'm the guinea pig.
Yeah. Yeah. I think she's doing great.
Yeah, she is doing good.
It's not easy to tattoo. It's a completely different type of art.
Yeah, it ain't like drawing.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's pretty fucking crazy. But speaking of wife material, we have something interesting here. I didn't even know this was a fucking world record.
Everything's a world record.
But I guess it is. I guess stopping a moving fan with your tongue is a thing people do. And what makes it better is a woman did it. There's a picture of her. She was stopping moving.
Gee, Casey, I wonder why you picked this.
I couldn't tell you, but it gave me and is right now the strangest boner.
Is that video like going to show her doing it?
Yes, this video does show her doing it.
Okay, well, fucking play it. Just turn the sound off. Maybe we'll be okay.
Oh, of course, there's a fucking advertiser. Yeah, we'll just
mute
that.
Turn the sound off.
Yeah, we'll just mute that real
quick. Well, we'll talk while it's playing the ad.
Yeah, fuck the ads.
Somebody's getting a
fuck the ads coming straight from the underground. But yeah, so there's a world record, I guess, for stopping fans with your tongue. She does it a bunch of times, I guess.
Damn, that's kind of impressive.
Yeah. And they're not just like plastic fucking fans, they're metal fans. I guess that's a part of the goodness.
Of course it's Italian.
Yeah, and she's Italian for some reason. I don't know, she's sort of weird looking. I'd do her.
She got that. She got that old 50s hair.
Yeah, she does. God, man, she must spend a lot of time in that hair. How do you even get your hair like that? She hula hoops and
a TV show. TV show's makeup department, I assume.
I don't know. I think she does it herself. Oh my god. Oh, she's teasing. I gotta stop watching this.
Anyway, we saw the money shot. We saw her stop it. So
that's just Zoe Jesus Christ. Who's that guy next to her? Did you see that guy? Oh my god.
No better way to have a show than use other people's content. By the way, obviously we should probably stop just talking about the video because our poor freaking podcast listeners are like, what the fuck's going on?
I know, and that's the thing. I really didn't want to do that because of our, you know, iTunes listeners.
Yeah, we have far more audio listeners than we do YouTube viewers.
But I just had to because that, you know, gives me a rager.
So where are we at on time here?
I think we're good.
I got time to throw in another one?
Yeah.
All right, cool. I got a pretty bizarre one here for you. So this lady, apparently eating placenta is a thing.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Yeah. So apparently,
sign me up.
Yeah.
Does this go along with the semen restaurant? I'll take a Schlong Island iced tea.
Well, apparently that's a thing people do a lot of times. It's some ritual. I don't know. Yeah. Anyway. So this mother, God bless her. She fears a burglar has eaten her placenta.
That's not the P word I thought you were going to say.
if you've eaten her penis, we got other questions. But anyway, this is in New Zealand, which is almost Australia.
Yeah, almost Australia.
My wife has a friend in New Zealand. I really got to try to negotiate that into a vacation one of these days. I would love to go
just
there.
Just don't die.
No, I think New Zealand.
And avoid the seafood. Dude, what would you do if you see Tupac? Like, you're sitting there just waiting for a bus and you just stand right next to him.
I don't know.
I would get a picture
with him.
But
it's New Zealand. It's not Australia.
Okay, you're right.
They're close, but anyway, so she was moving.
Mm-hmm.
And she left her washing machine and fridge and freezer. We're still at the old property, and she hadn't moved them yet. So there was some like frozen meat and shit in her freezer, and there was a Tupperware container with a fucking placenta in there. And she's afraid. Yeah, it says, my mind's still blown, Burns said. in the freezer was some meat that was supposed to go into the rubbish in a plastic container that has my placenta in it. Burns kept the placenta after giving birth to her now 5-month-old son, Dante. She said it had huge sentimental value and her family had planned to bury it somewhere significant.
Oh my God, it's not a dead animal. It's not a dead
pet. We are going to bury it with my partner's mom's ashes somewhere really special.
Why is this thing? What the fuck is wrong with people? Jesus Christ, man. I don't act this way when I lose a tooth. I'm going to bury it next to my mother.
Well, it says, I hope to God, I have to hold my fucking mic stand.
Yeah, Jay threw his fucking microphone last week, so it's like, you
know. It was for humor, God damn it.
Yeah.
Anyway, it goes, I hope to God I get it back, and I hope no one eats it. That would torment me for a long time. She couldn't recall whether or not her midwife had put a label on the container, so maybe they thought it was a pot roast. I don't know. God. Her message for the burglar was simple. Please just drop it back. I don't need to know who you are or why you did it. I just really want it back. No questions asked.
Baby, come back.
She believed the outlook probably wasn't good, though. She goes, I presume the only reason they stole it would be to eat it.
Oh, my God. What the fuck is wrong with people? Jesus Christ, man.
I don't know, but I'm going to need to find a pair of pliers.
This makes the South Korea and fucking guy killing old people look sane.
I beg to differ.
Jay, like, I can't believe. Is it fixable?
I think if we tighten it up with some pliers,
what part's right. broken?
This here is loose.
What? This part?
This screw.
Oh.
I think we can tighten it with pliers.
Oh my God, you freak!
If you hear a lot of movement on the microphone today, it's because I have to hold it.
Yeah. Actually, you fucking. You,
there we go.
You're like. Your thing's really low, too.
Well, that doesn't really matter. It's held in by freaking straps.
Nah. Got like the... Actually, you know what we should get? We should get the colorful ones that, like, Axl Rose used. Like, the cover mics here. Like, we have cover mics, but they're, like, black. I want, like, an orange one.
We should get that. Look at this shit, though. It's a glorious golden color underneath these things. We got to get pop filters so we can take these off.
Okay. Oh, yeah. I forgot about that. Yeah, if you look at these mics, they're gold.
They're glorious. Look at them. It's like we have fucking money, but we don't.
Yeah, but we don't. We got Tupac microphones.
We got that Tupac money, dog.
They're just spray painted gold. Actually, I don't know why I want to bring this up, but I was talking to my stepdad yesterday. He's in the car business. He says that airbags in cars are threaded with gold. So people in bigger cities and stuff steal airbags for the gold.
Really?
Yes. I never knew that.
I didn't know that.
It's a little tidbit there for you. I forget what else he said that they put gold in. Oh, yeah. He said when he was in the Army, they had these rocket launchers.
George was in the Army?
Yes, he was.
I did not know that.
Yes. Actually,
you learn something every day.
Yeah, he was in the Army, and he said they had these rocket launchers. I don't know, maybe Cricket, if you're listening to this, you can. I don't know if they still use these or not. But
confirm or deny, perhaps.
Yeah, but the whole guidance system, I think he said, or how the rocket is launched, is all used by gold. Like, they use gold for the launching system for some reason.
So when they wanted to buy them Vietnamese hookers?
Yeah.
Sucky, sucky, $5, so do I.
You too, Boku. But this was, I think he was in the Army in, like, probably the 70s, so I don't know if they still use these or not. I don't know, Cricket, you could probably confirm that or not, but I don't know. He said gold guidance systems. I forget. But
whatever. Fantastic.
Yes. But, yeah, speaking of that, I think that's about all the time we have for today.
Good, because I'm getting tired of holding my microphone now.
Actually, the way you're holding that microphone, it looks like one of those games where you hit the balls. Oh, man.
That made a very satisfying noise.
Yes, it did. Reminds me of when I beat my girlfriends. But anyways.
I think I just broke the mic. I just heard it buzzing.
Oh, great. I know, like, you just broke the fucking thing, and you're sitting there pounding on the goddamn thing.
I didn't hit it that hard.
That's what she said. But anyways, yeah, so.
I think our cable's just shit. They were $1.
Yeah, they are fucking. So like we said, thanks again, Cricket. We're going to put you on the wall of badasses. You've been awesome. We just want to say thank you again. We are on Twitter. We are on Facebook. We did say we're going to do a better job of posting stuff on there. A lot of the stories that we covered and everything.
Yeah,
like
we
that.
Say that, but we're probably not going to. So whatever.
I've got it, damn it.
Anyway, hey, and another little plug here. You can't walk around naked, so if you can't be naked, you should probably buy our t-shirts.
That was good. I like that. Yeah, and we're also on Stitcher. You can find us on iTunes, Google Play. All that good sexy stuff.
Sexy.
Yeah. Me and Jay are going to get going because I have World of Warcraft to play.
And I have to fix. I apparently have to fix a mic stand.
Yeah. So thanks again, everyone, and have a good night. Thank you.
Later.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.